quite flat. Okay. And then from here, run priority start.
Hello everybody! Again, welcome to my channel, Cycling Bug. Katulad ng sinabi ko in my previous video episode, cycling is passion and an enthusiast is looking for an ultimate experience. In this video, I am going to share with you my ride of a lifetime experience. But of course, I have my family with me. It's really a blessing to have a support from them. Pero syempre, sa huli na ang cycling pleasure namin ni Mark Will, my son-in-law, who will be my cycling buddy on this cycling adventure. So first, family tour muna. First stop pa lang namin, grabe. Excited na kami ni Mark Will. You know why? Because the place is Amsterdam, the city of bike or the bicycle capital of the world. Palagay ko wala na kaming makikitang mas maganda sa paningin namin kundi ang libu-libong tao na nakasakay sa bisikleta. The city is owned by cyclists. Nag-aapuro silang lahat sa mga kalsada, unbothered by traffic rules. Yung mga motorista alam yan. The city is equipped with elaborate network of cycle paths and lanes. Napaka-safe and comfortable. That is why people use bikes as the easiest mode of transport. And check this out. Ang daming parking para sa mga bisikleta. Amsterdam has a lot of bike parking facilities. Libre for the first 24 hours. After that, you have to pay for a small amount lang naman. There are about 900,000 bikes in Amsterdam. Tara, libot muna tayo.
Hannaford House 9, less admissions 30 minutes before. Less admission Heineken Experience 7 p.m.
We stayed for 3 days in Amsterdam. Hindi ko na ipapakita yung ibang lugar na pinuntahan namin. From here, we will travel going to France, the venue of a ride of a lifetime. I am so excited. This is our train going to France. Our travel was very comfortable. If you want to travel a high-speed rail from Paris to Amsterdam, Brussels, and other parts of Europe, Thalys is the best choice. Ang galing! It is both reliable and fast. 300 kilometers per hour lang naman. If you want refreshments, just walk down to the Thalys bar and buy your drinks and snacks. But take note, guys, you have to make a reservation if you want to ride on this train. Siguro napansin ninyo, wala kaming dalang bisikleta. We cannot bring it with us because as you can see, we have a lot of movements here, horizontally and vertically. A lot of walking. Obviously, we cannot carry our bike with us dahil madami kaming dalang bagahe. Plus, we have with us my grandson who needs to be carried almost all the time. So, paano kaming magbabike? I will tell you later. In here, we transferred to a night train going to Lourdes, where we will stay for the rest of our cycling adventure. This train is equipped with beds for sleeping. So, eto na! We are here in Lourdes, and this is our hotel, our home for the next days for our ride of a lifetime. Itong mga street signs na ito, sa Tour de France ko lang nakikita kapag nanonood ako ng race. Pero ngayon, I am blessed to see them with my own eyes. So exciting! Dito, we are on our way to Luz Saint-Sever to pick up our rented bikes. Sa mga nagtatanong, how we were able to arrange everything for this trip. The air transportation, accommodation, train tickets, car rentals, our rented bikes, everything that we need. All credits to my daughter Little and son-in-law Mark Will. They exerted efforts, do a lot of research and inquiries to make this trip possible. Every detail was perfectly arranged. Point-to-point destinations were seamlessly reached. Hindi kami nahirapan. Months before our flight, reservations and bookings were made. Next time ulit, ha? Renting the bike online is simple. You just need to give some details. Ilang araw mo rerentahan, type of bike, is it road or mountain bike? All specifications na magfi-fit sa'yo. Crank arm length, stem size, frame size, every detail that you want to customize. The rental shop will adjust everything according to your preference. This is Veronique, our driver and tour guide.
Where it will be quite flat. Okay. And then from here, Rampaiole, it starts to climb a little bit. Okay. But the beginning of Col d'Aspet on this side is quite okay. It's not that steep. Yeah.
How about here, from here to
okay.
here?
here, the beginning is quite okay. The average of the climbing, it might be around 3-4. Okay.
So it's like a warm up for us.
Yes. But then from Artigues is where the Tourmalet starts to climb more. Okay. So up to 9 something.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
This we have a little bit of a warm up here before we arrive here.
Okay. So we start with the Tourmalet up to the top.
Yes, then we
then going down and then to Col d'Aspin, okay?
Yes.
And in this case, we could stop at La Mangie for lunch, for
yes,
example.
Yes,
because they have plenty of restaurants.
Yes.
Because on the other side, it's a big bit more complicated.
Okay, we will do that. We, from top, we descend to La Mangie and we have a lunch and continue to Col
d'Aspin. Let's go. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Sounds like a plan.
Ready, everybody?
Ready.
It's going to be a very challenging day.
For us.
For them. We're going to have fun following you. We're going to be your big fans, like,
oh my! This is real! I'm sure na hindi ako nananaginip lang. I am in the cycling arena of Tour de France. This is one of our bucket lists. We are passionate cyclists and we want the ultimate experience to conquer the same legendary climbs of the Tour de France champions katulad nila Eddy Merckx, Fausto Coppi, Gino Bartali, Jacques Anquetil, Bernard Hinault, Greg LeMond, Miguel Indurain at marami pang iba. Ang dalawang pares ng mountain ranges, the Alps and the Pyrenees, are home to some of the Tour's most challenging and decisive stages. Nandito tayo ngayon sa Pyrenees Mountains. For us, kapag nakapagbisikleta ka to some storied and historic climbs of the Tour de France, it is something that a cyclist would treasure. It may not be the most difficult or impressive, but remember, it is the road of the cycling legends. For a cyclist, riding the famous climbs of the biggest cycling event in the world is a ride of a lifetime. Nandito na tayo ngayon sa Sainte Mare de Campan kung saan tayo mag-uumpisang magbisikleta. Ang target climb, Col du Tourmalet. Ang layo nito ay nasa 16.9 kilometers. The climb has an elevation of 2,115 meters towards the summit. Magmula sa Sainte Mare de Campan, kapag ka inakyat mo ito, you will have an elevation gain of 1,275 meters with an average gradient of 7.4%. Ang pinakamatirik na portion, 13% pagkalagpas ng Limongi. In the history of Tour de France, the first cyclist to climb in the Tourmalet is Octave Lapize in 1910 with his single speed bike. And take note, rough road pa ang kalsada paakyat noon. Itong Sainte Mare de Campan is famous because of its role in the Tour de France. Kasi from here, accessible ang iba pang ruta ng Tour de France like Payol, Col du Tourmalet, and Col d'Aspin, which I will feature on our next cycling adventure. Abangan nyo yan, guys!
Wala lang magdala.
Are you excited?
Yes.
Come on, guys! Relax! Come on, guys!
So, eto na. we started to roll off. Kasunod namin dito ang support car namin with my wife and daughter who are taking the video for us. Pasensya na kung medyo shaky ang mga shots. This is the first time na mag-video shoot si Little and we are not that prepared and equipped to document this ride.
We are with Veronique.
Our goal is to reach the top of the Tourmalet. So, pacing lang ang takbo namin. Mahirap naman yung ibigay namin lahat yung lakas namin pero hindi naman kami nakarating sa finish line. So, we just enjoy the ride with the famous road and sceneries. Dito medyo nahihirapan ako sa ahon kasi isa lang ang kamay ko sa handlebar. Yung isa may hawak akong camera to take footages. It is difficult to climb if using only one hand because you cannot completely put power on the pedals. Tourmalet.
Ha. Hirap. Pero okay lang. Full feeling.
In the roads of France, cyclists are fully respected. Kung mapapansin ninyo kapag nag-overtake ang mga motorist, they give much distance allowance from the cyclist. Kasi alam nila being overtaken by a car is stressful to cyclists, especially when climbing. And of course, it is for the safety reasons. Dito, pumapasok na tayo sa bayan ng Limonji. Medyo malapit na sa pinakamatirik na ahon, 13% gradient.
This is the Limonji. Ilang kilometro pa doon?
5.
dito?
From dito for.
Wala kami pambili ng tubig. Wala kami pambili ng tubig. Bili na kami sila. Ah, sige.
We have to stop here in Lemonji to refill our bottles. Hinintay muna namin ang support car kasi nakalimutan namin magdala ng pera pambili ng tubig.
Hello, Apa!
Surviving!
Now we'll go to our final climb, the Tourmalet.
This vehicle, ito yung tinatawag na camper. Madami nito ang nakikita natin sa Tour de France. Camper kasi sa daan na sila natutulog kapag sinusundan nila ang stages ng tour. Many cycling fans are camping together, having fun, and enjoying after the race. I hope in the future makapag-rent din tayo nito. Who knows? Another thing that makes you motivated on the roads of Tour de France are the spray-painted markings na ginawa ng mga cycling fans. Kanya-kanya silang sulat sa mga pangalan ng paborito nilang siklista. In the eyes of a cyclist, it looks legendary beautiful. Breathtaking sceneries are your consolation climbing the Tourmalet, plus the sights you can see on the road. Diyan pa lang, sulit na ang pagod. It is worth climbing the summit.
Wait for Mark Wildau.
Here is the steepest section. Dito, pagod na talaga kami ni Mark Will. The route is quite steep with no recovery gradient. What a feeling at the top of the Tourmalet. This is a milestone for us. Definitely, I will not forget this event in my life. A ride of a lifetime experience. Mark Will and I, although exhausted, were happy, contented, and amazed. Kung bibigyan pa ulit ng pagkakataon, I will climb again this legendary Col du Tourmalet.
Okay. Oh. Yay! Finish! Oh, yes! You have to do it again!
Yeah.
Let's see how much you have. How are you?
That's right. Yeah.
Pagkatapos ng ahon, syempre, mas masarap ang lusong, di ba? Now, it's time to have our lunch. Nandito na ulit kami ngayon sa Lamonji. This is the end of our Tourmalet ride. After lunch, we will proceed to Col du Aspin. Abangan nyo yan, mga kaibigan, on our next episode of Ride of a Lifetime. If you're interested and want to know more about cycling, subscribe to my channel, Cycling Bug. Bye for now, and see you again!